Make sure you like, comment, subscribe to the show. Pelicans lose to the Kings. Before we get into the show, this podcast is sponsored by the Birdsall Law Firm, the official injury lawyers of Boot Krewe Media, located at 918 Poitras Street by the Superdome. Give them a call at 504-523-5413. If you or someone you know has been involved in an accident, Birdsall Law Firm, the official injury lawyers of Boot Krewe Media. Lito, Chaz, Ross, joining me. I think Five just joined.
What up, Five?
Five's in here.
Hey,
hey,
Justin,
well,
does Birdsall do any criminal law?
Why is that?
Because there was a murder out on this court in Sacramento. Our defense was left bloodied and beaten. I just didn't know if they could call them and get a head start on that case.
So I'm glad I got through the read because I'm going to let y'all have it tonight. I don't even want to facilitate. Like, just go. I mean, there's nothing else. We keep repeating ourselves. Lito, they threw a 2-3 zone at us.
Fuck all that. CJ was a negative 27. He was a negative 27. I don't care. I'm sorry for cussing. He was a negative 27. Bro, get off the ball, bro. We have to find somebody. We talk about accountability. We talk about all these things. We talk about who is orchestrating what. My question is the coaching staff not watching this? Okay, I get it. His hand is hurt. Like, I'm not trying to bag on CJ, but like if your thumb is hurt, if you can't shoot the ball, facilitate the just be the primary facilitator. Hold on. I think he was 6'4", like 16 or something crazy. Like,
you look at my tweet, he's in his last five games, he's 12 of 44 from deep and 37 of 89 from the field. That's 27% from the 3-point line, 41% from the field. And
yo,
I completely agree with you because, okay, he actually did admit his thumb is hurt. It's a ligament issue, right? So then why would we be shooting the ball?
I don't know. And Ross, I'm going to cut you off. I'm about to let you have it. And I really, like, after this, I don't know what to say. I don't know what I'm supposed to say here tonight. Like, what am I supposed to say? I'm tired of standing up late for this.
I feel you on that for sure. No, I can't remember a game where I can vividly point to the exact play where it changed. Like, and it was a made basket by the Pelicans was when the game changed. Somewhere in the 8-ish, 9-ish minute mark of the third quarter, just start the third quarter, trading baskets. I think we're down 2, I think. CJ comes down, plays one-on-one, gets into his bag, as they all say, makes a basket, oohing and eyeing. The ball, before that, the ball's moving around. We're moving it. Guys are cutting off the ball. Everything, I thought the offense looked great. Yeah, we're trading baskets a little bit. We weren't getting any stops, but still, I thought offensively we looked great. That single possession does all that. Makes the basket. The next possession, he comes down and turns it over. 2.5 minutes later, we're down 11. That was it. The game's over. Done. That was it.
Five. Chaz.
Look, stars win games. This team's sole star player is one star on this team. His name is Zion Williamson, and that's why this team doesn't win any games. That's why they didn't win any games last year. That's why CJ never won any games without Dame. That's why Brandon never won any games in his 7 years he's been playing in the NBA. And this is what it is. Stars win game. You know, inflation and market value. That's why I personally think, and I wanted to ask AD this question, I don't think player salaries should be public. Because if I didn't know that CJ and Brandon were max players, I would just be like, well, you know, LeBron said they trash. It is what it is. You know, I would just
crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy because he was talking about CJ and Brandon.
Bro, LeBron, he only 2 teams playing.
Yeah, LeBron was talking about CJ and Brandon, and he said his son is washing y'all, and I'm not convinced that he not. So that being said, yo, this is a team you blew out last game. They came in, you know, they were motivated. Immediately, there was a sequence in this game that told me, like, it is bad. Because the Kings, they were doing everything they could do to let the Pelicans win this game early. And in the second quarter, Murray missed a wide open three. Herder missed a wide open three. Herb Jones came down. Herb Jones made like two, three threes
in the
first.
Three total.
And it wasn't the first half, right?
Two in the first half, one in the third.
Yo, come on. Like, the fact that Herder and Murray are blowing wide open threes and Herb Jones knocks them down, that goes to show you everything you need to know about this game. It was a fluky game. You're lucky to be in it. Brandon missed defensive assignment after defensive assignment. Dyson Do-It-All, Dellavedova Daniels was terrible. One of the worst draft picks in recent.
Chaz, let's not get crazy. Chaz, let's not get crazy.
Okay, you're crazy. All right. He was a really bad pick. He was awful pick. And I thought JV was decent in the first half offensively. Other than that, yo, stars win games. And then, until the dude comes back off his hamstring injury, this is a fringe lottery G League team.
Five. They threw a 2-3 zone at him.
Man, the zone has been killing the Pelicans all season. It's not.
What would you point, like, why is that a struggle for this team? Is it not enough practice time, preparation?
No, I told you.
Tell them five what it is.
It's coaching, bro. At the end of the day, it's coaching. I mean, Mike Brown and his staff ran circles around Willie Green and their staff. Ran circles. Like, they were winning games, and he was getting on his guys about certain things.
You saw that.
Yeah.
Who was that with?
That was Keegan.
Keegan, right? And Harrison Barnes, I think, was in the group. Yeah.
And then you see, like, their veterans, like, help, like, Dellavedova. Like, they were getting what they always get, no matter who was on the court. No matter if Fox was there. No matter if Monk was on the court. It didn't matter. They know what they want to do, and they know what they're good at. Like, first half, there was a couple plays where it might have been second half. They were running this, like, kind of dribble handoff, right? And then I think Trey Lyles did it first. I think Kyra tried to jump it, and he just – no, Herb tried to jump it
first.
It's Herb and Duncan. Yeah, Herb tried to jump it first, and he just went straight to the basket. I'm like, that's a basketball play. Like, forget the play. Like, you did something stupid. I'm going to take advantage of it, and I'm going to get a layup. And then you do it again with another player three possessions later. Like – that's a smart basketball team that knows what they want to do and how they want to play. The Pelicans just don't know who they are.
Why can't we do that, though?
But it's the same roster besides Dyson Daniels. Like, what am I missing here? What changed? What changed?
No, man, you can't sneak up on anybody anymore. People know who you are. You just don't know who you are. That's the problem. Everybody else in the league knows who you are. You just don't know. You got cats like CJ that, you know, time after time, like Ross said, pounds the ball into the ground and messes up the rhythm of a game. Like, bro, get off the rock. You ain't shooting like that right now. Get off the rock. Let it move. Let it hop. And then you can find some rhythm off that. When you try to get into your bag, this ain't even that kind of game. It's not even that. Like, we couldn't win a game where Fox wasn't there. And he kills us.
Yeah. Hold up. So, I want to go back to something that AD said last night, Lito, because AD said, and he came on the podcast saying that when he was in San Antonio, they would always get into the big man first possession, and they would go through him. Tonight, they go through Jonas. First possession of the game.
Yeah.
I think they get a good look. I don't know what happened, but it was a good look.
He made it. A little hook.
He's five for five.
So Lito, tell me why you play through him.
Yeah.
You're successful and you go from it.
I mean, he gave you 19 and 12, Justin, let me ask you this. Real talk. What number game was this in the season? Does anybody know?
67, 68?
Yeah. 65.
So let me ask you this: 65 games into the season, are you surprised that they went away? Like, is this shocking to you that they went away from him?
So then, okay, is that a player? Is it a player problem? Or is that a coaching problem?
I refuse to believe that it can't be a point of emphasis it can't be a point of emphasis to me, and the guys are just blatantly disregarding it. Like, I fail to believe, because then, right, where's the accountability in that? It's got to be coaching. But also, I think it's just a basketball, like 5%, I think it's a basketball IQ problem. Like, why don't the Pelicans, why don't we guard other teams like they guard us? Why don't we play other teams when they have a deficiency how they play us, right? Ross said that he noticed the game was over at a particular point. I noticed the game was over at a particular point too, Ross. And it was in the second, it was the halftime interview with Jen Hill and Casey Hill. And Casey Hill said, you know, we're fine trading buckets with them. And, you know, I thought about this and I'm like, I don't think he knows who's on this team. Like, he hasn't had, he is no way he's been coherent the last couple games to understand. Like,
games? The last couple?
I'm sorry. There's no way he's been coherent this season to see what's been happening with this team to think that you can trade buckets with the third best team in the Western Conference, even without their best player, so to speak, right? Like, they got guys over there, Kevin Herter, Keegan.
Oh no, I can't. I gotta stop. I gotta stop you. I can't hear about what? The players. I can't hear about the players. It's not the players.
What is
That's
it?
Why when Chaz was a second ago talking about stars, this, that, and the other, we just played a team that ran out a bunch of dudes that a lot of teams didn't want.
Sabonis is a star.
Sabonis is a star. Yeah, he's a great player.
Yo, they got good players, though.
Atlanta didn't want her. They're fine players. They're fine players. We didn't lose to players tonight. We lost to a coach tonight.
Wait, whoa. Ross, you've been. Wait a minute,
wait,
sir.
Hold on,
Ross. Hold tight. Ross, you've been. This is kind of odd out of you, sir. You've been just a big component of it being a player-led thing. I've been dreaming it's a coaching thing for months.
They ran layup lines on us tonight.
Who doesn't run layup lines on this team?
Fair point. Fair. Right. We tonight, two specific things. They ran layup line. They don't sit here. That's my whole point is, like, these were not – like, they just hit open shots all game. Like, I don't – what are our defensive principles? That well, I'll say no time. Know. They don't exist. Secondly
– what are offensive principles then?
They don't exist either. We just couldn't beat a 2-3 zone. Like –
we can't ever.
How can I blame players in a situation? Those are that if we just went out there and missed a bunch of shots, off night, whatever. Like we missed a bunch of open shots, it is what it is. All right. Like if you lost a close game late, like we just got bombed, and they ran layup lines. It was uncontested. I mean, we're talking about straight line drives here. We're talking about dribble handoffs and just step into threes. We're talking about coming off, this was one of the worst defensive efforts I can recall seeing in like an incredibly long time. Because the other part is the thing we all give Willie credit for, and that AD talked about last night about, you know, guys trust him, he gets them to play hard. We didn't play hard, and we hadn't played hard in a while. But you want to know the difference between last year's team and this year's team? At least last year's team got into people defensively. They played hard defensively. We banged guys around. We did things to at least make it a little difficult. Now, guys hit shots and we lost games.
Yeah.
Ross.
This effort was pitiful. That was pitiful effort defensively.
Let me ask you this, though. All right. And I get it as a coaching thing, right? But as a professional athlete, how many times do you think you've seen a 2-3 zone in your life?
Oh, I mean, a lot.
You shouldn't be struggling with
all of middle school and high school, basically.
You shouldn't be struggling with that. Like you really should hard. Struggle with
it. I mean, we actually screened the zone actually and got Jackson Hayes rolled the goal and they got fouled and we just didn't do it again. No. It's just basic stuff here.
Justin, before you continue, I just Ross, this is I just want to talk about this for just a bit. We have problems with offensive plays. We have problem with defensive principles. We have the team, not we, because I'm not a part of them. The team has problems with getting the ball inbounded. The team has problems with timeouts. The team has problems with rotations. That if these problems continue to exist, they fall at somebody's feet. And I don't think it's just one person's feet they fall at. I think it's a whole group of people. And they need to be talked about. The cat Casey Hill, Sorry, bro. He's just not it. He doesn't help Willie at all. At all. Like, he leaves him out to dry all the time. I'm sure they have to change strategies every quarter. Every quarter, because what he brings in doesn't work.
Five, which one of them do you think is helping him, though? It is my question.
I mean, to be honest, I don't think the defensive principle, because they do certain things really well. They've gotten better at certain things, like statistically. And I can see where that lies. But to be honest, the offense is so bad, it hurts their defense. A lot of the runouts and stuff, a lot of the live ball turnovers hurt so bad that it makes your defense look worse than it is. Like, they could be a really good defensive team if they just made buckets and just, instead of, you know, the team inbounding the ball out the basket rather than, you know, just getting a turnover and turning
it. Yeah, five. We had two possessions either in the third or fourth quarter off made baskets where they just like beat us down the court and hit an open three. Like,
bro,
that's an effort, bro.
Hey, when Najee Marshall let Kevin Herter dunk the
ball, drive around him and dunk it. Yeah,
that's when I knew it was over. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a direct correlation to CJ doing what CJ does, right? Trying to, like, it takes the air out of the ball. It does.
Sure. Can I add? I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, Chad. My bad, Chaz. Go ahead.
No, I just wanted to add this, bro. Look, I'm not a Willie Green fan, but dude's been in the league 10 years, 7 years, and every time they have to step up and be the best player on a competent team, they just don't deliver. Like, all right, Brandon, you got Elvin Gentry, right? That was probably Brandon's best year, in my opinion, right? He's out of here. Stan Van Gundy didn't deliver that year. He's out of here. Willie Green didn't really deliver last year. Some fluke stuff happened. We got into the play-in, whatever. We won 36 games, man. That's a failure. It's a failure. Right? It's a failure. Like, let's not playing these games.
Chad, he had some pretty good playing games and playoff games, but
that's adorable.
I'm so tired of hearing about. Jeez,
I mean, you can't just disregard what he did in the playoffs.
No, you can't. No, Justin. I'm so tired of hearing about what this team accomplished.
Let me just close.
We beat the Spurs. That's stupid. The Spurs were losing on purpose.
Sorry, Chaz. That's stupid though. But go ahead.
Let's let me close with this. All right, CJ, bro. I understand CJ's hand injury or what have you, but even defensively. Some things I don't think have nothing to do with coaching. There was a loose 50-50 ball scenario. Brandon doesn't go for it. Ends up it becomes an offensive rebound for the Kings. They hit a big three, you know, huge play for them, right? Then there's another play. Brandon fell asleep so many times, bro. So many times, bro. It was unbelievable. It was like, nah, something must be wrong. I thought he was hurt. I was like, something must be wrong, right? Some of these guys just aren't, you know, they're just not that tier or that caliber of player. Because, again, if everything has to be ideal for you, there's plenty of coaches in the league that aren't good. People were ready to fire. What's my man's? Who was it? Budenholzer?
Yeah.
People were ready to get him out of here. But Greek, Chris Middleton, them dudes stepped up. Drew Holiday, them dudes stepped up. Them dudes won like 15 games in a row. No one in the NBA thinks, with some of them games without Giannis, no one in the NBA thinks Mike Budenholzer is a good coach. Even Doc Rivers, everyone knows Doc Rivers sucks. Like, Doc Rivers ain't no good coach. Like, Doc Rivers, you know, but sometimes the talent, they're not playing that well right now, but them dudes is old. Like, the talent is supposed to, like, elevate. The cream is supposed to rise to the top when you talk about NBA talent and caliber of players. Zion doesn't have a problem winning on this team. Why does everyone else have a problem winning? Like, come on. Like, it got to be the players at some point. It got to be the players somehow.
Five, can we get back to, like, I want to get back to this Brandon Ingram thing. Yeah. Are you throwing away what he did the playoffs and in the play and stuff? Or are you All just
right. Listen, I'm going to tell you this story. Kennedy's basketball. This is the first year playing basketball.
So really? Big K.
Yeah, Big K, right? Their team didn't win a game all season, right? All season. But they made the playoffs. Okay, cool. They lost the first round game. Cool. They got into the loser's bracket. There's only four teams. They're playing for third place. They won the losers bracket. They won it. They won the game. Kennedy made the all-star team on a team that didn't win one game. All I'm saying is, yeah, you can be really good on a bad team and get rewarded for it. I'm not discarding what he did. All I'm saying is, can you be a really good player on a really good team that, you know, I don't know because I've never seen it from Brandon. It's in his year seven. You can say Tatum is,
even people Tatum gets a healthy Jaylen Brown, and
but Jaylen
Brandon
Brown,
doesn't get a healthy Zion.
Who Shea got though, Justin? Shea got a bunch of guys, random guys. Tyrese Halliburton got his best co-star is probably Miles Turner, maybe.
But we're Buddy better than Hill. Both of those teams. Like we're better than both of those teams. But
you don't think Zion being out?
That's what I'm saying. That's the thing, right? Zion, if Zion has to play, you can't win games. That's a problem.
The comparison, we've done this a million times, y'all. Comparison is not – forget Zion. Forget it. He ain't here. He ain't ever here, okay? Yeah. Forget what that looks like. I'm serious. Like, I like him. He's great when he plays. He ain't here. He's not going to be here. Like, I don't know where he is, what he's doing, but he ain't playing, okay? He hadn't played for a while.
Bro. Come on now. Just say he just hasn't on the court.
He's not on the court. That's what I mean. Like, he's out there, yeah, whatever. But he's not on the court, okay? And he hadn't been on the court for a while. The comparison is not this team with or without Zion. The comparison is the team we have right now today versus the team that we had at the end of last year and the way they played, the effort they played with, the principles they played with, the toughness they played with. Like, yeah, that stuff was lame when Willie Green was all saying it and everybody was kind of like, oh, ha-ha, yeah, like, this probably won't last forever. But the fact is, like, we don't play hard anymore. Like, I don't find that we play with any level of toughness whatsoever. Like, whatsoever. We get pushed around a lot of times. It's always like this, oh, the referee's not giving us this, that, and the other. Brandon was getting pushed around, and then back on the other side, we get a call. Like, why is it every game? Like, y'all want to say, are we conspiracy theorists? Like, the whole league's out to get – no. Like, no, the league isn't out to get us. We're just not a very tough team.
I just don't think we're just collectively intelligent team. I'm not saying there's not smart basketball.
We ain't that either.
I think that's the issue. That's the real issue because you can't out-effort everybody every time. You know, like you're not going to be able to do that. You're just not. Like some days you're just not going to have it. Can you beat the teams you're supposed to beat because you're just more talented and better than the other team?
Let me ask you this. Do y'all think that going into this game, did you feel like the Pelicans would win this game?
I did. I don't know why, but I did. When I saw Fox out, I was like, okay, we should be able to handle it.
I foolishly did because I thought the Pelicans had more talent than the Kings. And I've been proven wrong and wrong again.
I'm glad you said it.
I would take four quarters over a torn counterfeit dollar any day. And that's what the Pelicans have, a bunch of counterfeit dollars. Pelicans have two counterfeit dollars. And one of them hurt, so he got a slick side excuse. Two counterfeit dollars. It's year seven and year 10. If you're in the 10th grade and you can't read, you have a problem. That's a problem.
Go ahead, Fire.
No, I was going to ask you a question. I didn't think this team was going to win this game for one particular reason. I just knew – I feel like Mike Brown is the type of coach that can get guys to perform better than what they are, right? And he can, all right, my back's against the wall. Cool. Let's see if you guys can perform without De'Aaron, right? Without him there. And they did. They figured out a way to win games and beat a more talented team.
Because they play the same way every single game.
Yeah.
Who, you've been preaching that. Like we don't play the same game to game. We don't know what team we're gonna get. And to your point, Ross, the effort's just going out the window. But Lita, I'm gonna let you close this up. Like, is Wednesday a must win at home against Dallas?
Every game since
every game
has been a must win. Like
have lost so many must wins.
Bro, we should start saying they're must loses.
Must
losses, must lose.
I'm trying, guys.
I feel like I feel like – so Brandon had 24.7 assists, right? He was 9 for 16. He had 6 turnovers. I mean – bro, I don't know.
Make sure you like, comment, subscribe.
Shout out to Herb Jones. Herb almost had a triple-double.
I want to shout out Aramis Jones, man. Appreciate you and all your support, man. Shout out like, to Aramis, man.
Free Kyra. Keep freeing Kyra.
Mediification on the way.
Ready for the underdogs, the upsets, and the unbelievable action from DraftKings Sportsbook. The biggest tournament in college basketball is here right now. New customers can bet just $5 on college hoops and get $200 in bonus bets instantly by using code BOOT right there. Chaz, Lito, 5, Ross, must win on Wednesday night. We'll see y'all later.
Must win the game.